Hello friends, welcome to Tech Dose, and in this video I will show you how to reverse a linked list using recursion. So let us take three elements 1, 2 and 3, and what we will do is that if we are at 1, that is the head element, then we will divide the linked list into two parts, the one element and the rest of the elements. And what we will do is that we will first reverse this rest of the elements, and when we return back in recursion, then we will just make the next pointer of 1 point to its previous node, which was null. Okay, so I have already written the code. The one in the blue is the termination condition, the one in the black is the recursive code, and the one in the red is the operation for a given node. So let us just dry run the code by using three nodes. First, what I will do is that I will take a previous node pointing to null, and I will take a current node pointing to the head pointer, and then I will just slide one node at a time. These termination conditions are if not current then return. That means if the linked list is empty, then we will not do anything. We cannot reverse an empty linked list. The second termination condition is that if not current next, that means if it is the last element, then what we will do is that we will make the last element of the linked list as our head, and then the current next will be equals to previous. That means the last node will be made as head, and its next pointer, which is this one, will be made to point to its previous pointer, and we will return. Otherwise, if there are elements in the linked list and the current node is not the last node, then we will reverse the rest of the elements to the right by passing the current node as the previous node for the next one and the current next. And when this function returns, then what we will do is that we will just make the next pointer of the current point to its previous pointer. Okay, so this is how we will reverse. So let us just dry run the code. I have taken previous as null and current as head. What I will do is that I will just call the rest part and reverse it. Okay, so this will be run, reverse linked list current and current next. So I have already made a table for one. For the node 1, we have previous as null and current as 1. For node 2, the previous will be 1 and current will be 2. Since this is also not the last node, we will again call the right hand side of the linked list. Okay, so 3 will be called with the previous value of 2 and the current value of 3. Now since 3 is the last node, so our second termination condition will run if not current next. That means next pointer of 3 is null, and so this will be run. Now head will be made equals to current, so this will become head. The second thing is current next is equals to prev. You can see that for node 3, the prev value is node 2. So the next pointer of 3 will become 2. Okay, and then it will return. So when this function returns to 2, then we had already run till this line, reverse linked list, and now the last line will run. That means current next is equals to prev. So for node 2, our current value was 2, so its next pointer will point now to 1. So this link will be gone and 2 will point to 1. Okay, and then it will return. Now when we come back to 1, then what we will do is that again we will just run this last line, current next is equals to prev, since all the lines have already been executed. So this last line says that current next is equals to prev. That means the next pointer of 1 will be made to point to null. So this next pointer from 1 to 2 will be gone, and this will now point to prev. And we had already updated the head pointer when we reached the last node in our second termination condition. So this is how we reverse a linked list. If you have any problem, then please comment below. The next thing we will do is run the code. This is our code for reversing the linked list using recursion. I have already created the linked list, and then what I will do is I will print the linked list in order to see what I have created, and then I will just reverse the linked list, and then I will see what the result is. So in the reverse linked list function, I am passing two variables, that means two parameters. One is null, which is equals to previous, and the other one is head. I had shown you that the first current value will be head and its previous value will be pointing to null. So we are passing null and head. So let us see the reverse linked list function. In the reverse linked list function, as you can see, we have taken node star prev and node star current. Okay, these two are our termination conditions, as I had already explained, and then we will call the reverse linked list function, which is recursive, and finally when the recursion returns, we will just make the next pointer of the current points to its previous pointer. Okay, so let us now run the code. If you have any problem regarding this code, then please comment below. I will definitely help you. I will now just compile the code. As you can see that the code has been compiled, and now I will just run it. You can see that I have created 7 nodes, 1 to 7, and the reverse linked list is 7 to 1. So this function is working just fine, and I will post this code in the description section below, so do check it out, and if you find any difficulty, then please comment below. I will definitely help you. If you find this video helpful, then please hit the like button and subscribe for more such videos. Thank you.